Hello, my YouTube family, it's me, Lindsay, and, yeah, I guess I'm gonna be talking to you guys today. Woo! I'd say, yeah, it's time to talk about the weekend. I know the last time I had made the vlog was Friday, and, yeah. What has been happening since, then? Well, plenty, and you can say that I was kind of mad. What happened was Friday, my father was here, and he did a very bad job of mowing the lawn. So I'm like, what the heck? So I ended up trying to mow the lawn. I started off a little bit, but I was trying to start it up, but I couldn't get it out there yet. Well, I went back in because I was getting bitten by the bugs, and it was on a Friday evening. So, put bug spray on me, went back out, started the lawnmower, got about nearly one. Nearly one strip, then it stopped. I went to turn it over, and without hitting the without touching the blade, I moved the grass with my right hand. Now, I don't know if it was because I put so much bug spray on me, and probably it also got all around me, but when I went to grab the grass, my right hand was kind of burning in a way. But then after I got rid of the grass, I wanted to try to turn it back on, but it couldn't come back on. So then my mother got home, and now she does not want me to continue on. Now my mother does not want me to do the grass. And because of this, I feel this is a kind of a sexist thing. And I mean, we're both females, for crying out loud. But she doesn't want me to do the grass. Even though if my father would be here, he would agree. I mean, why is that? I mean, I really want to do the grass, but they want my brother to do it, but my brother does not do it because he bowls. I try to tell them that, but they don't care. Let's see. Of course, not much, but I my mother and we went to Walmart to get necessary things. Especially, I had to get replacement for toothbrushes and stuff. And if you guys had seen my video a little bit, yesterday I posted, it was, you know, it was kind of ridiculous, but yeah, it was kind of a ridiculous routine. I said, so yeah, but let's see what happened yesterday. Besides, I made the video. Not much, I guess. Ugh. But yeah. And anyway, first thing happened was actually during the last couple of days is I was looking and for information. I was looking to see how Chris was doing, and despite of what happened, you know, I was looking forward to see him more of wrestling a lot, but I only found out just Friday day he did wrestle. But unless I'm not mistaken, but unless NXT is dividing up the roster, it's kind of a weird situation. But when Friday happened and I saw Friday happened and I couldn't believe how crazy Chris was, but I was just glad he wrestled. Now, a lot of people, I have seen throughout comments and stuff, and a lot of people are wondering about Chris's merchandise, and let me just tell you guys, I don't know why everybody was wondering why is where they could find the shirts that he wears, or why there isn't any. Is I have no idea why about that, but I will find out soon. But if you guys are like really interested in his in the shirts that he has worn, and this, as I feel, I feel like Elva. And then of course there's the KO. That's actually available on ProWrestlingTees.com. And if you guys had noticed on my channel, if you guys are on my channel, I mean, desktop wise, not mobile or I know it's kind of ridiculous, but just hear me out. Let me just. I know you guys are wondering, what's going on, let's see. Well, if you guys have gone to my, if you've gone to my channel, apparently on my desktop, probably, actually you may see this under the, probably in my about page if you're on the mobile. Oh, dang it, I had 56, now I'm down to 55, crud. Shoot. YouTube's messing around. I'll mess around again. Yeah. Anyway, as I was saying, if you go on, if you're looking at the about page, or if you're like looking at my channel, though, it says my banner, it says weird art, but I mean me, because I did that. You see here it says Twitter, and then I have 5 others. It's Google Plus, Instagram, Blogger, Twitch, where I'm still trying to figure that out. And then it says here, I put as Chris Heroes merch. And the reason why, if you guys were wondering, and if you guys were wondering why I do not have merch yet, is because I'm going to wait until I have, like, 25,000 subscribers. And maybe I will do one. But as of right now, if you guys are wondering, if you guys want to purchase it, just go to the icon that is like that little megaphone, and I'll also include it down the link down below, so you guys can check that out yourselves, because he does post. I mean, he wouldn't tweet as much about this, but, and I don't know what anybody else would, but I will. talk about this. So if you guys really want to see, if you really want to purchase any of his t-shirts, it's available on ProWrestlingTees.com, and don't worry, he gets all the money. So until like Pro Wrestling Tees is forced to like close it, which I'm pretty sure that's much the case would be, but yeah, so I will have that. I will show you. I will leave the links down below. I will leave the link down below, and I will leave you to his where his tees are at. Anyway, let's see what else. Okay, so today I'm probably gonna email back this woman, and we're gonna see how this goes. But right now I'm trying to gather up stuff of today because I'm trying to gather up money, still doing some crazy stuff, so I can make sure I have enough to my Amazon gift card balance. Apparently, I went to check out on Amazon on a couple of times, and apparently they changed it to $35 there's if I did not have Amazon Prime, which I don't. Even I would sign up for the 30-day trial, I could be in trouble with my mother. But it's right now, it's like you're allowed to spend $35. It really changed from. Oh, did I just exit it? Oh, crud. I did not fully exit that on purpose. Like I said, I don't know why Amazon did, but it was 49, but now they went back to 35. It just became so bizarre. So anyway, oh yeah, and the other thing, I forgot to put a link down, but here's the reason why I forgot. Because I'm trying to remember the battery that does, and I sort of forgot. There is a big battery, but the one video I was looking at, I remembered that I thought it would do all three. It was costing like $60, but it only did phone and tablet, so I guess I nearly screwed up. But I think there is one, but video I was looking into, but there's probably another one. Kind of ridiculous in a way. But anyway, so before I will talk to this person to get the stuff, I'm going to make sure I have enough. Actually, I will talk to this person probably today, but I will also make sure I have enough, because I will do that. But anyway, I will be looking into that today. Now, if you guys were wondering if I was okay on Friday, besides that, I was not much okay on Friday because I was kind of thinking about, mostly because of Chris, because of what happened, that I got very angry because I was angry at myself, mostly because of what was going on with Chris. And ever since I heard about him coming back to WWE, it nearly got me very upset because there were things that I think this is probably something I have to deal with when I found out back in December, prior to his birthday. And if you guys don't know when his birthday, it's December 24th, which is Christmas Eve. Yeah, if you guys have looked into my, if you guys look in my past videos, let me pull it up. Where is it? Of course, I had a I know I haven't been doing any reviews of television shows as of late because I got very angry and upset with what's going on, but I promise you guys I will try to talk about that. But I think, yeah. Yeah, I made a video back about 4 months ago, and I think that was around December, wasn't it? Yep. It was December, and I was very upset. And I think Chris knew how upset I was. I'm pretty sure he does. I'm pretty sure he probably heard that I was upset, but I made a video about that about 4 months ago, and ever since I got very upset, and I guess after when I, last time I tweeted to him was, and he responded back to me, was around his birthday, but that's when things were getting really bad because of, and it was not his, and he was not mad at me or anything, or I'm not really mad at him, it's just that somebody was causing trouble. And the reason why I made that video about 4 months ago is because somebody who I thought Chris trusted, I guess you can say, really went at it yet again. And this happened before, and I think it was about roughly two years ago, and he got very angry and upset, and the rumors turned out to be not true, but now it happened again, and I think that this time around, I think Chris was mad, and I guess he did not wanted his fans, including me, not to know about this. And despite if it is true or not, for somebody to go out there and say that kind of stuff, they shouldn't just mind their own business. And he did not want nobody to find out. And I really did not want to be honest, I did not want this to ever happen again. I mean, I was really looking for, because what happened was around last year, when I was watching him before this whole entire situation went out. But when I was watching Fight TV, there was a problem with streaming. I didn't know it. I felt it was not their fault, Fight TV's fault. The reason why I'm saying that is because of what happened, but I was, really was looking forward to seeing Chris Russell, but there was some problems. I think it happened during last year's WrestleMania weekend. I thought it was Fight TV. It wasn't. It was those people, not my end, not Fight TV's fault. I was gonna blame them, but despite I'm still missing some of their stuff that I was getting, but didn't get it. But and then when I was in, 'cause then I got really angry around October last year. When I was in Florida, visiting family members, and also seeing other family members I haven't seen since my aunt's wedding over 2 decades ago. All because of my grandmother. And anyway, and when I heard about this announcement, they switch over. I knew from the start it was trouble, and it was bad. It was, and I think it still is going at it. And I don't know how long. And it was not fair enough for me to see. It was not fair enough to make not let me see Chris Russell. Crying up again. Because right now, because I'm thinking about Chris as much as I'm thinking about my grandmother. I'm sorry, guys. I shouldn't be crying like this. Try my best. Anyway, so yeah. I couldn't, and yeah. When I heard about my phone around January, this past January, when my phone started to blow up with notifications, and I was wondering what the heck's going on. And besides, when I, cause I follow, cause besides that, I do follow, Jordan and Ian and Craner on Twitter as much as Kian and Zine and and all the and other and even Emma Bakari. But all that aside, the rest of my notifications are upon with wrestling, and when I heard about when I heard that, when things were starting to surface, and I was like, oh Lord. And I think what made me very more angry and upset was the fact when I saw the tweet from WWE, Vice President of Talent Relations, Creative and Live Events, and Paul Levesque tweeted, at his Twitter account at Triple H, and they sent out this photo, and I got very angry and very upset, and I was so angry. So, anyway, when I saw that photo on that January 5th, this is weird. It's a photo from January 5th, and this is May 1st. Good grief. I know, it's the reversed. But anyway, I was in shock, and besides how deplorable, I was mad and angry because of how the photo was, but at the same time, I was like in shock, stunned, that I had to see Chris with a tie. In a suit with a tie. I was like, there was no way he would do that. But the weirdest part is him in a suit and a tie, and the shirt is blue, but I've seen that blue colored kind of shirt before. And then it just made me hit, and then just end up realizing who I was thinking of. His former student that he used to, that he had trained in Chikara, Tim Dantz. And you're probably wondering, Lindsay, why are you saying this? And I'm like, because all I remember was in his photos on Facebook, he did like some kind of photo shoot, and I found out that he decides that he was revealing he was trying to do his I guess you could say his best Superman impression, but decides that revealing that he was wearing a T-shirt underneath of it, but the shirt and the tie, I mean, the shirt was blue and the tie was black, and I was, and him wearing a jacket, and I'm like, and then when I think about, when I compare that to Chris, it is the same color. I'm like, what the heck's going on? I'm like, oh man. Suddenly, all I can remember is that. Okay. Oh, yeah, that's what I remember now. Besides, I ended up talking about Chris because it made me feel better, I guess. Besides that, I really do care for him more. Even though I've been kind of lately a little bit distracted because of my family, and sometimes I'm also watching YouTube, so can't help blame me. But anyway, now I remember why, because I posted on Instagram about what happened the last couple of days, besides how mad I was about our yard has not been fully cut because my father decides to duck out of his responsibilities, and because of that, my mother wants my brother to do the lawn, but I know that's not gonna happen as much. Is yeah, I do remember I had posted this, even though I'm wearing the same shirt yesterday as much as the videos, because I'm not gonna change it yet until after this video, but I just realized. I also put down that I'm gonna put a video up today, hopefully. It's how to make instant ramen noodles and with some do's and don'ts. Because after all, I didn't really
until I forgot yesterday that it happened yesterday. You see, my mother really stinks at cooking when it comes to food, like food. Because what happened was, she took the instant ramen noodles. This is Nissin and instant ramen noodles. And she did it like it was, like if she was cooking it as, she said it was soup. It wasn't soup, okay? There's a difference between as a noodle dish versus a soup. And the difference is it was more feeling like a noodle dish. It's like if she was cooking her, and, how to say this? If she was, like, cooking pasta or those egg noodles else that she get puts with gravings and have it with our dinner. But yeah, but the way how she took the instant ramen noodles was kind of bad in a way. She did not follow directions, because that's why I got so mad at her. And I did not say anything to her, but despite I was kind of thirsty in a way. But there was the problem was, she cooked the noodles, but she left probably, she probably must have did was, she put them aside, she took the flavorings, probably mixed it in a bowl and on the side. Ugh. It was so bad. And I don't think she even followed directions. But that was not, it did not feel like eating soup. I don't know why she could. It was soup. I mean, it was instant ramen noodle soup. And she just make it like it was a noodle dish. I mean, the only time if you do that, you take, it's actually, there's a dish, I remember, because I'm not sure if it's still there. There's a restaurant downtown called Tsukasa's. I'm not sure if it's still open, but there was a dish that it's usually would be cold buckwheat noodles, I think. And you have some kind of, and you eat it, but with like some kind of base. It's, like, it was, like, a dipping kind of sauce, but it's, like, I think it was soy sauce, maybe. I'm not sure. I had that before, and it was really kind of good, in a way. But I think that was what, I don't know why, but I got really angry about how she cooked it. When we have that, oh, so this is what happens when I talk so long. Sometimes my phone starts to screw me up. So apparently, hopefully today, I will have a video about cooking instant ramen noodle soup. Instant ramen, yeah, how to do, cook instant ramen noodles the right way versus how my mother did it. I don't know how, but I should have just gone down when I heard her trying to cook it, and I should have yelled at her. But it to me yesterday, it did not felt like it was not soup. Because of it. And before you guys get mad at me, and why did I say, why is Nissin, what is Nissin? Nissin, and because that's what the package says. It's a it is a Japanese company that makes instant noodles. It's Nissin food and noodles. Yeah, it's apparently their products are sold in the United States. But I don't know who does that, but yes, it's been sold in the United States for quite a while. Stoffices. Yeah, but I think probably would be sold in. Probably we have offices and probably the closest one probably in So yeah. So they're the ones who are, so apparently that's when I got mad at my mother. So yeah, so I'll probably today I will have a video out there to show you how to make instant ramen noodles. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna wrap this up because I know I've been recording this for 30, about for 36 minutes, and I may have to go and edit it because my video just decided to mess around. But anyway, guys, if you guys will, if you are new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button yeah, and I will catch you guys later. Oh yeah, and if you guys are wondering if I'm going to be doing any gamings today on my gaming channel, that's a little bit iffy. I will promise you guys I will try to stream. I'm probably going to do Minecraft Pocket Edition. I just have to see if, because they updated again, and I guess a couple of days ago after the last blunder I did, but I promise you guys I'll do much more better, okay? So anyway, guys, I'll catch you guys again real I'll catch you guys again sometime today. See ya. Bye.